We need to have glossy lips, right, when we're talking about summer? Well, hello, my lovely nestlings, and welcome to my channel. Today, I am going to show you my 15 summer palettes. What does that mean? These are palettes that when I open them up, I think of summer. I think of beaches, I think of ice cream, I think of summer. And if you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 45 from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And I'm very kind of neutrally and soft today. It is one of the looks that I like to do when it is very, very hot outside. But I also, as you will see in this video, love me my colorful eyeshadows. And if that sounds like something that you can vibe with, if you love makeup just as much as I do, if you are very much into color, or maybe you want to get into color, or you just want to get some inspiration from different color combinations, maybe you're like me and you're a light olive and you're like, I don't really know how colors behave on my skin tone, then make sure you are subscribed, because this is definitely the channel for you, and I would love to have you as one of my nestlings. Yes. Okay, shall I start with what I have on my eyeballs today? Maybe that, well, I don't have a lot on my eyeballs now, do I? When it is very hot summery weather, this is kind of the style of makeup that I go for, because it looks cute, it's quick and easy, and if stuff melts off my face, it's not that big of a deal. Yes? So the palette that I used for the pop of inner corner is this one from Odin's Eye. This is from their new collection, the Saga of Freya collection. And this is palette number 2, chapter 2, Cat with the Golden Carriage, or Cat's Breath. Palette, don't dig your nail in. This palette was sent to me in PR. And honestly, if I hadn't received this in PR, I would have bought this one myself. Yeah, here is the color story. When I opened this collection up, and especially this palette, the first thing I said was, this is giving me summer feeling. Yeah, and I have this shade in my inner corner and then this shade on top. I have actually done a video with the entire collection, and I will leave as many videos in the description box as I can. Go check out the description box anyway for all the information that you will find there on all the palettes. But yeah, very, very pretty, and the quality is very nice. You get different shimmer formulas, and it's just, it looks just so, so stunning. It, you know, it's, I love it. Yes. Never mind. I have a combination of drugstore and indie brands here. So let's kind of go next to a drugstore brand then. I don't think that this eyeshadow palette will surprise anyone. I think I have a few surprises in here for you guys, so not gonna lie. But this one, it won't surprise anyone. This is from Makeup Obsession. And Makeup Obsession is a sister brand to Makeup Revolution. So it is not... It is sold at the Revolution Beauty site, but it is not Makeup Revolution. That's how I understood it anyway. And this is the Sunshine Makes Me Happy palette. Yeah, what can I say? It's a yellow. The only thing that I... And the quality on this is very, very nice. The only thing I want to kind of bitch about is that these two yellows... Well, actually, the yellow mattes. These two are an undertone difference. And this one is basically this one blended out. So I wish that this one would have been... What I'm missing here is a very nice yellow shimmer and a darker matte. That is what I'm missing in this palette. But it does give me very, very much summery vibes. And yeah, if you're looking for a yellow palette that is small, cheap... And I want to say like me, but yeah, that's not... I'm not cheap. I'm very high maintenance. I am small though. Never mind. But yeah, this is definitely in contender. And I will leave all the palettes down below as well. Then the next one is from I Heart Revolution, which is a sub-brand of Makeup Revolution. And it is the Tasty Peach palette. And this is the color story. And this is just summery vibes. When I look at this, when I open up this palette, I get happy, I get summer feelings. I don't use it a lot, and it is a nice quality. It's not the best quality that I have in my collection, you know, let's face it. But it is a nice enough quality if you like the color story. And I have done a bunch of looks with this, and I have done and a few videos, and I had a lot of fun with it. Yes, then the next one is that the only one from them? Yeah, the next one was PR as well, and I also have a code with this brand. It's one of my favorite brands, and this may be a palette that you're like, really? That's giving you summer vibes? Yes, it's giving me summer vibes. It's from Nomad Cosmetics, and it is their Malibu Surf Shack Quad. This was actually the very first PR that I got from them. But yeah, This is the color story. Now, if you are an olive like me, this is basically your everyday neutral quad, honestly. There is just something about this color combination, and then especially with that minty, I don't know, there is something about this that every time I open it up, I am on a very, very warm beach. I live at the Dutch coast and we have a very nice beach here as well, and it's warm there right now, but not a lot of the time. So this, I don't know, this just makes me, I don't know, see myself sipping something out of a coconut and laying on a warm beach, tropical. It's the way it is. Yeah. And it is a type of look that I really love to do right now. So yeah, just this, this basically dusted on the lid, and then this in the inner corner, maybe even giving a hint of definition with one of these two shades. Yeah, quality is very, very nice, very blendable. What can I say? Okay, let's next go to a palette that is also from an indie brand, and this one I did pay for, and this is the Ready Set Summer from Max Up the Makeup. There is summer in the name, so how can this not be a summer palette, right? It's not a brand that is talked about a lot. This is was their summer release of 2018 or 2019. I think 2019. And here it is. The quality is very, very nice. I have done some very fun looks with this. And the fun fact is that the dark blue called Coast is... It feels dry, but it is... And very, very pigmented. But it is a very nice dark blue to use. You can... If you go in slow, it's very... You can create a wash of color, honestly. So, yeah... Max Up the Makeup Ready Set Summer Palette. It's a great quality, and honestly, I wish that more people would try the brand. Then I'm going to go to a European brand, and that is Glam Shop, the Modelova palette. This is newer to my collection. I think it's an older palette technically, but it's newer to my collection. And I think that Modelova translates as apricot, right? I don't even know if it's one word or two, but yeah, basically this is the color story. And this is giving me summer vibes. I almost want to sing the summertime song, you know? So, and this shade called Bacalia. Oh, this is such a stunning... It's a peachy with a goldeny and a greeny. And an, oh, it's a stunning... If you are eyeing Glam Shop Poland, I can highly recommend their eyeshadow palettes. I have currently 3 palettes from them here. They are all amazing quality, honestly. Yes, the Modelova palette. Okay, let's next go to this one, because I have it here. So I pulled this palette because this is a palette, or yeah, it's kind of the look that I could recreate what I have with this palette. And it is from Sigil. It is the Naked Kitty Cat palette. So here's the color story. And basically what I have right now, I can recreate with this one. These are very, very soft... soft looks that you can use every day. This is what I kind of want to play with right now. It's because of this type of look that I just love so much when it is very hot outside. So yeah, the Naked Kitty Cat palette from Sigil inspired. Okay, sure, let's next go to the... I think this is the last PR in the bunch. Yeah, this is also a European indie brand. It's actually a Dutch indie brand, and it's also the palette name, but also the color story. It's the summer palette from 5050 Makeup, and this was PR, yes. And I also have an affiliate code with them, and all my codes will be listed down below in the description box. But here's the color story. Now, honestly, this can go Halloween-y for me as well. And why is that? Because if you... basically, because like this, then I see Halloween-y. Yeah, but... It is called summer, so it should be in here. And it is a very, very nice quality. This yellow shimmer, I love this yellow shimmer. I wish it was a little bit more intense even, but I do really, I need more yellow shimmers like this in my life. I need a neon yellow shimmer, truly. Very, very nice quality. It's an amazing brand. What can I say? It's a lovely palette as well. Yes, let's next go then to a palette that is also older, and I actually don't really know if it is still sold. I think they had discontinued it, but then it was brought back. And I don't know if it's on the site right now, but I do know that a lot of people have it. It's the Tribe palette from Juvia's Place. Now, not only is it the color, but it's also the colors that are in here, especially the top row, but also this part. Yeah, it's just this is just, yeah, it's an amazing palette. It's an amazing quality, and I really do hope that it is still sold. I actually pulled in initially another palette that has been discontinued. That's the reason that it is not included here, because you cannot buy it anymore. In case you want to know, it was the Nomad palette, the Antilles palette from Nomad Cosmetics. It's a very, very summery palette, but you cannot get it anymore, so that is why it is not included in the video. And yeah, I don't really know if this then should be included, but it is. Yeah, what can I say? Then I'm going to go to also a palette that is newer in my collection, and it is from Kaleidos. It is their Flower Punk palette. This, let me put this one in the inner corner. Why? Well, because I can.
Need to find my mirror. Look how cutesy. Look how cutesy.
The look that I have right now, I can easily recreate with this palette, but I can also pull in this one or just the pink, because I really love basically a naked eye, and then with a liner falsies and a pop of color, especially right now. I love that. And this is just giving me summer vibes, especially if I kind of do this, like this, maybe that. And then here it's more autumn vibes. Let's next go to the next palette, which is from a drugstore brand. This is a new palette in my collection, and I did not think that when I bought this palette kind of as an afterthought, and it is my favorite out of the collection that they came out with. And it is one of the Say It palettes from BH Cosmetics. Can you guess which one? It's the Optimistic AF. This color story, it's just what I want to play with. It's what I want to play with right now. It makes me think of summer, but not just some palettes are more along the lines of early summer, but there's also, the late summer when the days are, you're going into autumn, and then there's that kind of that change, This palette gives me late summer vibes. Late summer, maybe early autumn, I don't know. It's when it is still warm, but the leaves are beginning to turn. That kind of vibe is what it gives me. Don't ask. The next one that I pulled from BH Cosmetics, is this a surprise? It's the Orange Sorbet. Yeah. When I see this, I think summer. I did use this on camera, but for members only. I kind of want to, maybe I need to do an Instagram tutorial with this, or just, I don't know, but I need to play with this, because this is just, I want to play with this. Yeah, what can I say? And the quality is very, very, very nice. They are bringing them back constantly. I think I saw that they were available on the German side last time I checked. Could also be the USA's, I don't know. But they are bringing them back regularly. So if you want one, I will link where you can find it. I hope at least. And otherwise, just keep your eye on the site. Yes. Then I have three palettes left. Yes. Oh, did I say these are not ranked though? I think I forgot to mention that. But yeah, the next one that I'm going to mention is, oh, from Juvia's Place. I kind of grouped them by brand, but I failed. So yeah, you get another one from Juvia's Place. It's kind of hidden somewhere in between underneath a bigger palette. It's the Sweet Pinks. I actually have not used this a ton. What I want to do with this palette is exactly the look that I have right now, and that is that pop of neon in the inner corner. That's what I want to do with this palette, because for me, on my eye, yeah, this one, because it's a little bit more of a peach. This one is, this for me is more inner corner work. This is a shade that it really pops and speaks to me, but when I put it on my face, it basically makes me very, very green because of the tone of the shade. This one is then a little bit more friendly. This one is also pretty as a blush, by the way. Just saying. Yes, let's stay in the pinks. Let's go to Ace Beauté, the Blossom Passion palette. It's the pinks. The orangey shade, and then the red. That combination, I think, is very, very pretty. But yeah, this is also giving me summer vibes. Maybe a little bit more Midsummer. I don't know if that makes sense, but for me, beginning of summer, then the middle of summer, and then the end of summer, they all have a different feeling, a different vibe. This is middle summer. Don't ask. I don't know why. I really like the quality though. And then the last palette that I'm going to mention, is this the newest one in my collection out of the bunch? No, the Odin's Eye was the newest one. This is the second to newest one. I did film with this. I had a lot of fun filming with this one, and this is also from a European brand. This palette I did pay for, but with the brand I do have a discount code, which will be listed down below. And it is the Lovers palette from VE Cosmetics. This is a bright palette with some neons in here. So here these three are neons. Oh, and this one is a neon as well. This one does not translate as a neon on camera, I know, and I don't know how to make it show up as a neon on camera unless I swatch it. So let me dig my finger in. I hope that you can kind of see how neon. No, it's still not. It's very, very neon. It's truly a neon orange. I had a lot of fun playing with this palette. You get a combination of brights, some more muted shades, and then some pops of neon, and then the top row are shimmer shades. Yeah, this quality is just so nice, especially for a bright palette. It was very, very easy to work with. If you are though having trouble working with neons or with pastels, the trick is, especially with pastels, use those on a sticky base, but also for me, neons I love to use on a sticky base. And I start with a brush that's a little bit more open, and then I tap on the first layer. And that's basically then I can kind of blend the top layer very, very lightly, and then I build it up slow. So instead of packing it on and blending it out, which usually does not really work with a neon or a pastel, I stipple, and that just works better. This was it for today's video. Let me know your summer palettes. Yes, if you have any, of course. Let me know yours. Let me know if there were some surprises that you had. I am very, very curious. Are there specific summer palettes that I didn't talk about that I need to know about? Let me know down in the comment section below. And then this is going to be it. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. May your foundation always match your neck, and I will see you very, very soon in my next one, unless I have melted. Then I will be a puddle on the floor. It was very dramatic. It's the heat, honestly.